Hi, let's get started with the using Cloudera Manager in Hue to access a Big Data Service cluster video. In this video, you will learn how to use Cloudera Manager CM in Hue to access a Big Data Service cluster. To ensure security, when BDS deploys a cluster, the nodes in the cluster are not accessible on a public internet. By default, the IP addresses for the cluster nodes are private. In this video, you'll learn how to access CM in Hue directly in a web browser. A utility node generally contains utilities used for accessing the cluster. For example, Cloudera Manager in Hue are installed on the first utility node in a BDS cluster, such as utility node 0 in our example. You can make the nodes in the cluster available using one of the following methods. You can map the private IP addresses of selected nodes in the cluster to public IP addresses to make them publicly available on the internet. We will use this method in this video, which assumes that making the IP address public is an acceptable security risk. You can set up an SSH tunnel using a bastion host. Only the bastion host is exposed to the public internet. A bastion host provides access to the cluster's private network from the public internet. You can also use VPN Connect, which connects a site-to-site internet protocol security or IPsec VPN between your on-premises network and your virtual cloud network. IPsec VPN is a popular set of protocols used to ensure secure and private communications over IP networks. Finally, you can use OCI Fast Connect to access services in OCI without going over the public internet. With Fast Connect, the traffic goes over your private physical connections. Using a bastion host, VPN Connect and OCI Fast Connect provide more private and secure options than making the IP address public. The table on the screen shows some of the useful resources that you can use to establish connections to the nodes in the cluster. All services are only available on certain ports. You need to define security rules on the subnet to allow access to those ports. To make a service available, you must open the port for that service. Port 22 for Secure Shell or SSH is open by default in the default security list that comes with each VCN. All other ports are closed by default. Security lists act as virtual firewalls for your compute instances and other kind of resources with ingress and egress rules that specify the types of traffic allowed in and out of the cluster. Ingress security rules expose HTTP and HTTPS routes from outside the cluster to services within the cluster. To use a specific service on a node in the cluster, an administrator must explicitly open the port associated with that service by adding an ingress security rule that allows traffic into the cluster. For additional information about security lists and rules, use the URLs at the bottom of the screen. The first requirement to enable CM in Hue to access the utility node in our BDS cluster is to open port 7183 for CM and port 8888 for Hue. We will add two ingress rules for CM in Hue to the default security list in our cluster's VCN. The second requirement to enable CM in Hue to access our BDS cluster is to map the utility node's private IP address to a reserved public IP address that you specify and provide your users with this IP address. For detailed information, use the BDS documentation URL shown on the screen. As discussed earlier, there are other private and secure methods to make the nodes in the cluster available. Log in to the Oracle Cloud Console. On the sign-in page, select your tenancy, enter username and password, and then click Sign In. The Oracle Cloud Console homepage is displayed. Click the navigation menu in the upper left-hand corner of the console homepage. Under Networking, select Virtual Cloud Networks. The Virtual Cloud Networks page is displayed. Click your cluster's Virtual Cloud Network. Next, we will update the default security list in our VCN. Only public subnets can have a public IP address assigned to them. Remember, when you created the cluster, you needed to specify that your cluster belongs to a public subnet. In the Subnets section on the page, click the public subnet for the selected network. Under Resources, in the panel on the left, the Security Lists link is selected by default. Click your default security list link for your selected network in the name column. The default security list page is displayed. Scroll down to the Ingress Rules section. This section shows the currently available security rules in the selected default security list. Next, click Add Ingress Rules. In the Add Ingress Rules dialog box, add the rules for the TCP protocol which enables you to use Cloudera Manager and Hue to access your cluster. You can customize this dialog box to meet your security needs. In our example, we're opening up the port to all sources by entering 0000/0 for the source sitter. Anyone on the internet can access port 7183 for CM and port 8888 for Hue. No egress rule is required to allow the response traffic. Update the source to a more restrictive sitter if required. For the source type, select sitter. For the source sitter, enter 0000/0. For the IB protocol, select TCP. For the source port range, enter all. For the destination port range, enter the port number that you'd like to use to access the cluster, such as 7183 for Cloudera Manager. Enter an optional description. Click Additional Ingress Rule to add the second ingress rule for Hue. At the bottom of the Add Ingress Rules dialog box, the Ingress Rule 2 section is displayed. Enter the following details. For the source type, select sitter. For the source sitter, enter 0000/0. For the IB protocol, select TCP. For the source port range, enter all. For the destination port range, enter 8888. Enter an optional description and then click Add Ingress Rules. The two ingress rules are added to the default security list. Let's start Cloudera Manager using our reserved public IP address, which we are not showing here for security reasons, followed by a colon in port 7183. On the CM login screen, enter your username and password. Remember, use the password that you specified when you created the cluster. Next, click Sign In. The CM homepage is displayed. Note the name of the cluster, the CDH version that we chose, and the services running on the cluster. From the Hosts tab, click All Hosts. The five hosts of our cluster are displayed. Hosts are configured with one or more role instances, each of which corresponds to a service. The role indicates which daemon, also known as service, runs on the host. Typically, a host will run multiple roles in support of the various services running in the cluster. Let's drill down on the roles associated with the master node in the cluster. The services and roles that are running on the master node are displayed, such as the HDFS name node, Spark History Server, Yarn's Job History Server, and Yarn's Resource Manager, among other services and gateways. The node also runs some gateways. A gateway is a type of role that typically provides client access to specific cluster services. For example, Hive and Spark each have gateway roles to provide access for their clients to their respective services. Click the Hosts tab, and then select Roles. The roles page displays a table that is grouped by hosts having the same roles assigned to them. For example, worker nodes 1 and 2 run the same roles such as the data node in Node Manager Services. Let's start Hue using our reserved public IP address, which we're not showing here for security reasons, followed by a colon in port 8888. The Hue homepage is displayed. For additional information on how to use Hue, use the URL at the bottom of the screen. The screen shows some of the useful BDS and OCI documentation resources. Thanks for watching. Learn more at docs.oracle.com, EN, Cloud, PaaS, Big Data Service.